Trees can be used to represent mathematical expressions, and you can use it also to visualize mathematical expressions as a tree. In this case, an operation is a node, and variables, or their concrete values, are leaves. In fact, we have here an example, a plus b times c times d. So how do we construct something like this? Well, c times d has precedence over the additional multiplication. So we start here as a leaf, c times d, c times d. And this result then should be multiplied with b. So we multiply this result with b. And then to this result, we have to add a. So that's basically our tree representing this expression. In fact, the compiler uses trees to pass the program syntax and particularly evaluates the expressions and makes sure that they are evaluated in the correct order. So here's an algorithm for evaluating an expression. First, what you need to do is you repeat this algorithm until you know the result at the root level. So you traverse our tree, and if you know the values of both children of the node, then you perform the math and replace the node with the result. And then you repeat this step until you basically have computed everything to reach our top level. Here's an example of our mathematical expression 4 plus 2 times in brackets 3 times 5. So that is represented as this little expression tree. And well, we can check, can we do this math at this node? No, we can't because we don't know the result here. Can we do it on this node? No, we can't because we don't know the result here. But on this node, we know the result and the values of both children. We know it's 3 and 5, so we can do the operation. So 3 times 5 is 15. Now we replace the node with 15. Now we know this node, so we can do 2 times 15, so the result will be 30. And then we can do this last operation, 4 plus 30, well, it's 34. So this was a very simplified algorithm, and it works, but it can be optimized by using an appropriate tree traversal. And tree traversals can be implemented or expressed as recursive algorithms, and there are three typical tree traversals. One is the pre-order, one is the in-order, and one is the post-order. So let's get started with the pre-order. What it means is, at a given node, you first process the element, then you traverse left, and then you traverse right. Of course, every time you visit a node, you repeat this algorithm, because that's why it's a recursive algorithm. So when we go from here to the left node, we would repeat the algorithm, meaning we would process the element. Then we would attempt to traverse left, but there is nothing to traverse. Then we would attempt to traverse right. There is nothing to traverse here. And then we go back. Now we would, on this node, traverse the right. And so this is how it is basically processed. And if you do it and would print for this node the expression, then you would achieve plus 4, because we start with plus, then we get to 4. Then you would get the multiplication times. And then you go to the left 2, and we go to the right 5. So that's basically the resulting pre-order of our expression. So the in-order is an alternative traversal. What you do here, you traverse left, then you process the element on the current node, and then you go to the right. In this case, it would lead to our expected expression. So we have here 4, we go left, 4, then we go process the element, we make plus, we go to the right, we go to the left, 2, we process the element times, then we go to the right, 5. So that's basically the expression. Lastly, we have post order. How does it work? Well, we have to traverse left, then we traverse right, and at last, we process the current element. That would in this case lead to 4, 2, 5 times and plus. Now you may wonder, why do we have those kind of weird pre and post orders? And it turns out, in fact, that they are really handy for the automatic processing. Pre-order and post-order can be evaluated by the computer without knowing anything about the brackets and precedence and ordering. They have these terms, they are called Polish notation, which is the pre-order, and the reverse Polish notation is the post-order formulation. How can we use this to evaluate the mass of such an expression? Well, we can use a stack and then we read the tokens. Here we start with the reverse Polish notation, by the way. So we read the tokens of the expression from left to right, so we start at 4. And if a value appears next in the expression, we push it on the stack. So we push 4 on the stack, then we push 2 on the stack, then we push 5 on the stack. Now we reach an operator times. What we do then is we pop the last two elements from the stack. So we pop 5 and 2 from the stack, and then we do the mass. So we know it's 2 times 5. And then the result will be pushed on the stack again. So in this case, we would push 10. And so we have 4, 10, and plus. We reach another operator. What we need to do is we have to add 4 and 10 makes 14. So that works and is a way how typically expressions are actually evaluated in our computer system. By the way, if you have no two items on the stack, then it's an error. It's like 4 plus. That doesn't work because you don't know where what to add to 4. Okay? So here's this example, a bit better illustrated because it might be a bit quick for you. Let's have a look. We have 4. Here we in this example we have this lengthy reverse Polish notation. So we start in our stack with 4. 4 is a number, no operation to be needed, so push on the stack. We get 2 is a number, push on the stack. The next token is 5, push on the stack. Now we get to times. Well, we know we have to remove the last two tokens and we replace it with the result. It's 10. Then we get to plus. Well, plus means adding the last two elements on the stack and pushing the result onto the stack. So we have 14. Then we have 3. Push 3 on the stack. Multiply the result means 3 times 14 is 42. That is pretty nice. Now what I ask you to do to evaluate in yet another expression is the expression 3 minus 2 times 1 plus 2. What you need to do to evaluate such an expression, you first have to create a tree representation and make sure that this tree representation covers the priorities or the operator precedence correctly, so our brackets here. Then you generate a reverse Polish notation from the tree. And lastly, you evaluate this result using our algorithm that we have just learned about. It may take you a couple of minutes. Have a look at those two slides. So this is how we represent the expression. So this is the way you generate the tree. And then have a look how to do generate the post order from such a tree. Once you've done this, you can use this algorithm that we've exercised here and you will be done. So pause now the video and have a go with it. It may take you a couple of more minutes than shown here if you do it alone. Good luck. Welcome back. I hope you made it to evaluate the expression using our algorithm and the reverse Polish notation. Here is the solution. Remember, our expression was 3 minus 2 times 1 plus 2. So first we have to organize our tree. So on the leaves, actually you will find always the numbers, right? So we have 3, 2, 1 and 2, because this is always how they must look like. Now we have to organize the inner nodes to make sense. We see we first calculate 3 minus 2, so we have 3 minus 2 as inner node, the minus, to organize. On the right hand side we have 1 plus 2, which we have to do first, and after those two results are computed, we have to multiply them. That really represents kind of this expression. And next you can basically perform the algorithm, and if you do so, you will get as a result 3. I hope that is enjoyable for you. I find it quite interesting that this works.